Today we will talk about the Ultra Wide Band Development Kit from Truesense. The Ultra Wide Band (UWB) refers to a wireless communication technology that uses a broad spectrum of frequency bands to transmit data over short distances. Unlike traditional narrowband communication systems that operate within specific frequency ranges, UWB spreads its signal across a wide range of frequencies, allowing for high data transfer rates and precise location tracking. First item of the kit is the Volcano board. Volcano allows easy development of customers' software application and product thanks to its flexible configuration that gives the option to be used as an Arduino shield. The second item is the DCU150 module. This module is a plugin to the Volcano board. The third item is the DCU40 module. This module is also a plugin to the Volcano board. The fourth and last item is the TTAG40 standalone module. This module is a standalone module and does not require the Volcano board to work. The kit has also one USB cable for the Volcano board and an adapter for the standalone TTAG module. These cables will be used later to program the modules. While the video shows how to plug the modules, I would like to give you some more information about the Ultra Wide Band technology. Key characteristics of Ultra Wide Band include 1. Wide spectrum usage. UWB systems use a large portion of the radio frequency spectrum, typically spanning several gigahertz. This wide spectrum allows for high data rates and increased resistance to interference. 2. Short range. UWB is designed for short-range communication, typically within a range of a few meters to tens of meters. This makes it suitable for applications such as wireless personal area networks, short-range radar systems, and precise location tracking. 3. High data rates. The use of a wide spectrum enables UWB to achieve high data transfer rates. It is capable of transmitting large amounts of data over short distances, making it suitable for applications that require fast and efficient data exchange. 4. Low power consumption. UWB technology is known for its low power consumption, making it suitable for battery-powered devices and applications where energy efficiency is critical. 5. Precision location tracking. Due to the wide bandwidth, UWB can provide very accurate time-of-flight measurements, enabling precise location tracking. This capability is leveraged in applications like indoor positioning systems and asset tracking. 6. Low interference. UWB signals are designed to coexist with other wireless technologies without causing significant interference. This is achieved by spreading the signal across a wide frequency range and using very low power levels. Applications of UWB include wireless connectivity for devices like smartphones, laptops, and smartwatches, as well as applications in the automotive industry for collision avoidance and vehicle communication. UWB is also used in location-based services, asset tracking, and industrial applications where precise positioning is essential. It's worth noting that regulations regarding the use of UWB vary by country, and it's important for UWB devices to comply with the relevant regulatory standards to ensure proper operation and avoid interference with other wireless systems. When connecting the standalone TTAG module, please make sure that the cable starts from the GND to GND and then one by one in sequence. Use the 5-volt pin on the adapter. While the video shows how to connect the TTAG standalone module to the USB adapter, I would like to tell you more about the difference between the DCU150 and the DCU040 modules. The DCU150 module has three antennas. This means that can acquire not only the distance but also the direction, or angle, of the remote UWB device. The DCU040 instead has only one antenna and can acquire the distance of the remote UWB device. Same thing also for the standalone TTAG module, as it has only one antenna. What we will show next is how to load the software on both Volcano and standalone TTAG module for sending it commands using a simple serial interface software program. The tutorial is based on using Linux Debian software distribution. Before you start, it is important that you have access to the three files showed in the video. These binary files are the ones that will need to be loaded into the modules so to allow them to be programmed using EAT commands. Save these files into a directory under your Linux home environment. Now you need to download the Truesense software from GitHub and store it in your home directory. You shall also unzip the files if not already unzipped. To build your software, start by updating your packages in Linux. The command is sudo apt update. In some cases, you will be required to enter your root password. Then you need to install all the packages showed in the video. The commands will be pasted in the description of the video. At this point, you need to change directory and move to the directory where you have installed the Truesense software from GitHub. Create a directory called build. Go to the build directory. Run the make command to generate GNinja. Run GNinja to create the executable. Install GNinja on your Linux computer. Move to the Linux directory where you have stored your bin files. Before you program your Volcano board, you need to insert the jumper on the ISPEN pins. Look at the video for more details. Such jumper will then need to be removed after the board has been successfully programmed. Now plug the USB-C cable connector to the Volcano board. Then plug the USB cable connector to the Linux computer. Run the command showed on the video and see the programming logs on your terminal. To program the DCU040 module, you need to plug it in the Volcano board after removing the DCU150 module. Be very careful when performing this operation so to not bend the connectors. After that, you need to connect the Volcano board on the Linux computer and run the same command used for the DCU150 module, but changing the bin file and replacing the one for the DCU150 with the one for the DCU040. After the programming is done, you need to remove the ISPEN jumper. This will allow you to use the Volcano board with the AT commands. Now you want to start sending instructions to your DCU module using the Volcano AT command set. Connect the USB Volcano cable to any computer. In my case, I'm using a Mac. Open a serial command application that can be downloaded for free on the net. In my case, I use WCH serial port. Configure the serial settings as you see on the video. Once connected, try to send a simple AT command. If the answer is OK, then your setting is correct. Now that your setting is done, download the AT command set from Truesense. The link is on the description. This allows you to test all the DCU modules and will help you to prepare your projects. One quick thing you could test is the WiMode command. This allows you to communicate with your mobile phone. Write AT plus UI mode and press send. Once that is done, run an application on your mobile phone called Estimate UWB. The free part of the application will allow you to discover the DCU module and see some interaction between them. As the last part of the tutorial, I would like to show you how to program the TTAG DCU040 module. This does not require the Volcano board but has a separate USB to serial adapter provided with the Truesense kit. As the Volcano board, also the TTAG module has the ISPEN jumper that needs to be inserted when programming and removed when accessed by the AT commands. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please follow my YouTube channel and find out more about other tutorials posted.